Hi friends, welcome to Ava Studies YouTube channel. This is part 30 in Azure Synapse Analytics playlist. In this video, we are going to discuss about how to use Pandas library to read or write data from Azure Data Lake Storage Gen 2 using Apache Spark Pool. So Pandas is a module or a library which has a set of classes and functions already created that will help you to read or write data from files. And those files, if it is available on the Data Lake Storage Gen 2, then how to read them and write them using Apache Spark Pool inside the Synapse Analytics. So that is what today's video discussion. And we are going to discuss about three types of files, like if it is a CSV file, how to read or write, if it is a Parquet, and if it is a Excel sheet. Okay. So what I will do, I will practically show you for CSV file, and also I will give you the hints the same way how to do for Parquet and Excel files. So you can try for Parquet and Excel files in the same fashion how I do for the CSV. Okay, so let me go to my Synapse workspace. So this is my Synapse workspace. Let me go to Management Hub under Apache Spark Pools. Let me create a new Spark Pool. Let me name it like maybe like Spark Pool 1. Okay, and let me select node size as small, and then maximum nodes also let me keep it 3 only, because it is only for demo purpose, right? Now let me go to the additional settings. So here Apache Spark version, select the latest version. So I selected 3.1. Right now this is the latest version. And now let me hit this review plus create button. I don't want to examine anything else. So let me hit this create button to create this Apache Spark pool. So this will take around 5 minutes to create this pool. Meanwhile, let me go to this development tab and let me hit this plus sign and create a new notebook. So once you open a new notebook, this is how it will appear. Let me minimize these general properties. Here you should attach with the Spark Pool whatever you create here. So right now our Spark Pool is under deployment, so it will take some time. Let's wait. So meanwhile, firstly, as I said, Pandas is a library, right? So before using that library inside the notebook directly, what you do, you should import that library first using this command, import Pandas. Now you will be wondering, how come this line automatically getting all that libraries for me inside my pool? So let me select this pool here, which is just now deployment successful. So what will happen now, if you want to use this same line inside your local local system, and if you want to run this code inside your local system, right, in your local machine, you should install Pandas libraries first. Then only your system will know, when it sees this line, it should know, okay, I should use a Pandas library what is installed in this machine, like that. But here there is no machine, right? This is in cloud, and we are trying to run this particular code on this Spark Pool. So this is Spark Pool automatically have that Pandas pre-installed actually. So that is the reason when you use like this import Pandas, then automatically pool is nothing but like a machine thing, like that. So in that machine, Pandas will be already there. So it will able to understand this, and it will start using the modules or libraries inside this Pandas. Okay, so I imported it. Now once you import it, there is under this Pandas, let me click dot here. So what it will do, it will give the intelligence also. So here there is something called this read CSV function. Okay, so this read CSV function actually helps you to read any file from your storage account. Now you will be wondering, how I should know what parameters this function expect, so what arguments I should pass. So actually here intelligence is not that good if you ask me. See here, it is not showing intelligence properly, what parameter it expects and all. So if you are already familiar with Pandas and all, you no need of to seeing any documentation. But if you are like me, who don't know or who is newly exploring, the best way is what I do, I will copy that entire function name like this, and I will go to the tab here. I will try to search like this, pandas.readcsv documentation. Once I hit it, it will give the documentation link for that particular function. And if you see here, this function expect all these kind of parameters. If you scroll down, for each parameter, what kind of data type we should pass, everything is detailedly given here. So there are so many parameters. So this parameter is required, file path, and some. So there are so many parameters, but you need to see which parameter is useful for you, and you need to pass it. So in my case, I should pass the file path where my file is there, and then also I should provide a connection information of my storage account. So for that, if I scroll down, there is one parameter called storage option. So here I should officially provide my connection information also. So how to do that, let me go here. So here firstly I should pass my path here, then second parameter what I will be passing is, I will be passing this one, right? So let me copy the storage options. So this is the parameter name. So let me copy the storage options, and here let me paste this storage options. So here, and this storage option type is going to be dictionary, if you see. So in Python, dictionary is nothing but like a JSON actually with key value pairs. So here what I should do, I should use like this, key in flower brackets, provide a key and then provide a value to it. So this is what I need to pass. So here I need to pass the file path, and then for the storage options, I should pass this dictionary. Okay, what kind of key I should mention, what kind of value I should mention, I am going to discuss now in just a bit now. If I go to the presentation here, if you see this, here I have explained how to read or write CSV file, right? If you see this line which is highlighted here, pandas.read.csv, here you need to pass the path of your file in ABFS URL format. That means your container name, then @, your account name, then dfs.core.windows.net/path of that entire file. Then under storage options, you can pass account key by taking account key of the storage account, or you can pass SAS token like this, or you can pass the entire connection string of the storage account, or you can pass the service principal as well. So using tenant ID, and client ID means service principal ID, client secrets means service principal password. So any of these dictionaries, whatever I highlighted here, you can pass them. So for our simplicity, I am going to use this syntax, account key one. Okay, so now let me go here. So firstly, let me make it into two lines so that it will be more clear. So here, let's try to provide a path. So if I go to my storage account, this is Mahir ADLS Gen2. So this is a Gen2 account. If I go to containers, so there is a container called ADF demo. Inside this ADF demo, under data folder, there is a file called employees.csv. Okay, so let's assume this is the file which I want to copy. Okay, so now let me take this URL, and now let me paste this URL here. But if you see, this URL is not the format in which my pandas expects. So here I should use this ABFSS syntax. So what I can do here, I need to convert this ABFSS, and then here next thing is I should provide the file system name. File system name is nothing but like your container name, ADF demo. Okay, so let me see the syntax, / then ADF demo, / then ADF demo, then @. After that, you need to provide the account name, that is Mahir ADLS Gen2, then .dfs, then .dfs, then .core.windows.net. Then here inside this file system data folder, then employees.csv file. So this is the path for it, for me. Okay, so this is how the URL has to be computed. And here, as I said, I am going to use the account key. So account key, in this dictionary, key is account key, and value is going to be my account key. Let me go to my storage account, and here if you scroll down, there is something called access keys. So from here you can copy that account key actually. So I'm hit this show keys, copy this key, and then go to your storage here, and then paste your key here. Okay, so that's it. So once you are done with this, so if you see this documentation of read CSV, it is going to return you a data frame, right? So the entire thing I am going to store it in a variable called df, which will get the data frame back. So here next thing is what I will do, display data frame. Let me do this. So now what we are trying to do, we are trying to use this read CSV function and take this entire file path in ABF system, ABFS format, in the ABFSS URL, then storage keys, pass your account key and password, and take that data frame, use a display function to display it. Let me hit this run button to run this cell, and let's see practically whether we will be able to view our file, I mean we will be able to read our file from the storage account or not. So let's wait for the execution to complete here. Great, see, we got our results back. So that means we are able to properly read the data from this particular file. Okay, so now let's assume this is the way you read the file. Okay, so now let's assume if you want to write the data back into your Gen2 account, then how to do that? So let me do one thing. This pandas library has a class called data frame. So this data frame class help you to build a new data frame on the fly by your data also. So let me see the documentation of this class first, so that I should know what values I can pass as a constructor. So let me go here, and here pandas data frame documentation, if I search like pandas.dataframe documentation, let me open this documentation. Here I should see, so you can pass your data, and there are a lot of other parameters too. So for data parameter, you can pass a dictionary. So what I am going to do here, for this data parameter, I am going to pass a dictionary like this. So if you see the screenshot here, let me see this. Okay, see here. So here for this data frame, right, we are passing a dictionary with a open flower bracket and close flower bracket, and this has two keys, name key and ID key. Assume like these are columns, and then the name contains a list and also ID contains a list. So same thing what I am going to do here, I am going to create a dictionary here. So ID is the first key, which is going to contain a list of values like ID 1 comma ID 2. Think like this, list is nothing but like your rows. Then another key called name, and for this values are going to be like maybe Mahir, and then second name is going to be maybe like Wafa. So now what this will do, this is create a class which is data frame type. So let me save this in a variable called df. Now on this data frame, what I can do, data frame dot, there is something called to CSV. Okay, so this to CSV function will help you to write this data back into a CSV file. Okay, so if you see this here, the intelligence also it gives you all the parameters, the path where you want to save that CSV, and also you can pass the storage account option here. So like how I passed previously storage account options, and then I provided the account key and account key value, right? Or I can use other authentication methods as well. So I am going to use the same thing here. So to CSV function. Okay, so let's wait here. I did something wrong. Maybe for this I passed a dictionary which is ID 1, ID, these are the values, name, these are the values. Let me hover this and see what is the error. Okay, error is not clear. Let me see, I think there should not be any error. So let me pass path here the same way how I did, how I passed previously, right? ABF SS, then double quotes, then your, let me copy this URL. So let me go to containers here, and from the containers let me go to ADF demo container data folder. Maybe I want to create a file here only, so let me open any file here randomly and take the URL, copy this URL, go here and paste this URL here, and let me convert this to ABF SS. Then my container name is ADF demo, that is what my container name or my file system name, then at the rate account, then dfs.core.windows.net. Then under data folder I want to create like employee1.csv, let's assume. Okay, and the second parameter is going to be, as I said, storage options, right? So storage underscore options. Okay, and for this we have to pass a dictionary, the account key information I have to pass, right? Account underscore key, the value is going to be account key, right? What I, let me paste. Okay, sorry, let me take the account key once again from my storage account. Let me go to ADLS overview and go to access keys, show keys, copy this key, come back here and paste it here. Okay, so now close this. Okay, so that's it. Now okay, this is on df1, right? So my data frame name is ds1, so df1.2csv. let me execute this and see whether it will successfully run or not. Okay, there is some error. Okay, error says unexpected indent. Okay, so there is a space, it looks. Okay, let me remove these spaces. Okay, that is what it's creating a problem actually. So let me remove this, all the spaces and everything. Now let me run this, it should properly work. In Python, right, spaces also will matter actually. See, execution completed. Now if I go to my storage account and if I go to containers and ADF demo under data folder, I should see employee1.csv file. See, that means I was able to successfully generate my data into a file. Okay, that means I was able to successfully write the data back into my storage account. So this is how you use this read CSV function to read the data, and also if you want to write the data, then you use this to CSV function. Okay, so same way, if you want to work with a parquet file, you need to use read parquet function. If you want to write back into if you want to write back the parquet, then use the to parquet. If you want to read Excel file, read Excel. If you want to write the Excel back into the storage, then to Excel. So this parquet and Excel, you guys take it as a homework and you just do it by your own if you want to know. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to get the notification whenever I add videos. Thank you so much.